here at Easton. I'd like to welcome you here. Very eager and exciting audience tonight, I can tell. So thanks for waiting for a little bit as we start in just a moment late. But I'm so glad we can share some music with you. It's getting really close to break. We're all feeling it. We're very excited we have this opportunity to invite you. So just a quick welcome and also a reminder, if you have flash photography or other things, you can make sure you don't do that now. It sort of is distracting sometimes to our singers. And we wouldn't want anybody to trip and fall or get confused. That's not good. Along the way, I'll stop and explain a little bit about some of the music we're singing, just so you have a little bit of a way of connecting the music that we're singing with your lives. So the next song is one that's a little calmer and a little bit more peaceful. Although it sort of describes the weather we're starting to get here. It's called In the Bleak in Winter, and it's not in your program, so I thought I'd just let you know. It's like one piece that we've inserted in the Bleak in Winter.
Famous reindeer of all. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you met a sight, you would even say hello. Down his stories.
welcome. I just wanted to make a couple of introductions here. I'm Christina Kahn. Who you just saw conducting the ensemble is our fantastic student teacher from Lawrence University, Morgan Moraine. You'll see her out here again in just a little bit. Our next song, she hasn't heard yet at all, because she's only here Mondays, Wednesdays, and every other Friday, and she also does band. So this is a surprise. Miss Moraine, this is for you. This is our first time hearing the song that we've been practicing. So here is Santa Claus Has Come to Town.
Three, two, one. There we go.
All right, while our varsity treble is coming onto stage, I'll tell you a little bit about this next piece. It's really hard. There are a lot of independent moving parts, and at one point we get to split the choir into five different parts. We've got a trio that's featured, we've got two TAs, we've got Deanna Cruz, we've got McKenna Carver, and we have a student who has been a part of varsity travel and is morphing next semester, and she's joining us for the semester. So we've got Eliana Kelly on the desk kit part as well. This is Dig It, Dig It, Dig. Thank you.
Oh. The scars of bedtime round their throats to keep their little heads from falling in the snow. Then I turn round and there you go, and Michael, you are bow, and turn the white so red as strawberries in the summertime.
There's this thing happening, it's called weather. And people were looking in the distance and seeing that Thursday there's a, I don't know, what is it, bomb cyclone or whatever fancy name coming our way. And if by chance weather affects our Thursday concert, AE Voices wouldn't get a chance to perform their set. So we said, okay, sure, we can do anything, we can throw them on this concert. So you're getting an extra bonus by watching these folks sing. And let's just say, if you know things happen on Thursday and we don't get a chance to be here on Thursday night, maybe also Friday. Who knows? It's not like the superintendent is here to make those decisions or anything. So in any case, I would just be happy to know that these folks get a fine chance to perform. I'll get out of the way, and I'm going to let one of our captains introduce the next part of our set. Welcome, Austin Demarath, and Mike Coyle.
We have two more songs to perform for you today. The first one we just sang was called White Winter Hymnal. That was Pentatonix's arrangement. The second piece we have is called White Christmas. It's a pretty familiar Christmas carol. Most of you probably know it. It's going to be in a little bit more fun, jazzy style, though, so that should be interesting. And then our last song is Last Christmas. Here we go.
Da do da da do da. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know. Where's a tree tops glisten and children. To your days be merry and bright. May all Christmas be white.
Yell and holler at like whoop whoop soloists at any point in the concert. Right now is the time. We feed off your energy, so during the song, this isn't like traditional like stand here and sing scared choir. This is fun choir. So you can yell and you can cheer while we're singing. That's okay. We feed off it. Okay. This is last person. This is our last song.
Give it to someone special.
I love backstage and listening, and there was some singing, but mostly what I heard was response. There's actually, what's so nice about that is that we talk about this in class, about how we feed off of each other's energy. And when one person really brings something that's powerful, we feel that, like literally feel it while we're standing next to them. We're breathing the same air and singing the same music, same rhythms, we're combined. That is fantastic. And as Austin set up, this is the kind of music that works really well for that sort of energy. And then what's great about music is there's so many shifts in different genres and styles. And so we're going to transition to some of those sounds that are a lot more contemplative, more sometimes more quiet, where the response is going to be a lot different for the audience. So as I always think about teaching about how we respond to music, this is one of those moments where we start to think about being a little bit more internal, and we can show some of that applause at the end. So there are going to be some solos that will happen in some of the next songs, and if you can wait till the song's complete and then show that appreciation, that will help all of the text and everything come out. That's just my way of saying, thanks for responding in all the right times and places.
Awesome!
I'm also practicing because tomorrow we get to sing this for 5th, 6th, and 8th graders. We get to teach them a lot about audience etiquette. Any case, next song is called Good King Wenceslas. This is a song about a 9th century saint. It was written with a 13th century tune by a guy who lived in 1832, and we're singing it now. If you didn't follow that, that's fine. See if you can catch the story basically about someone who has a lot of power and decides to use that power for good. This is Good King Wenceslas. Don't worry, a choir will show up at some point.
Thou shalt find the way. your fellow men be sure of the rank possessing, you now do bless the poor. Show yourselves my blessing.
Movie. If you haven't seen the movie, I'm not going to give any spoiler or anything like that, whatever.
You've probably seen it. But we couldn't just have, you know, like me read it, that'd be boring. So I'm going to invite out three people, two of whom you've already seen tonight, and one of whom some of you will recognize, because either he's you've had him as a teacher, maybe in sophomore class English. He's a kind of guy who floats around East. He's been here a long time. I won't tell you how long, but we're happy he's here. He graduated from East, and he came back a teacher. So we're going to welcome Austin Demrath, McKenna Carver, and our one and only Corey Otis to read to us.
Hated Christmas, the whole Christmas season. Now, please don't ask why, no one quite knows the reason.
It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right.
It could be perhaps that his shoes were too tight.
But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small.
Whatever the reason, his heart or his shoes may have been that his heart... He stood there because he hated the hoops.
Staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown at the warm, lighted windows below in their town.
For he knew every who down in Whoville beneath was busy now hanging a mistletoe wreath.
And they're hanging their stockings.
He snarled with a sneer.
Tomorrow is Christmas. It's practically here.
Then he growled with his Grinch fingers nervously drumming.
Must find some way to stop Christmas from coming. Why, for 53 years I've put up with it now. I must stop this Christmas from coming. But how?
Then he got an idea. An awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea.
I know just what to do.
The Grinch laughed in his throat, and he made a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat.
And he chuckled and clucked.
What a great Grinchy trick. With this coat and this hat, I'll look just like Saint Nick.
All the Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care, when he came to the first little house on the square.
This is stop number one.
The old Grinchy Claus hissed. Then he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist.
Then he slid down the chimney on a rather tight pitch, and he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist.
Then he slithered and slunk, with a smile most unpleasant, around the whole room, and he took every present.
Popguns and bicycles, roller skates, drums, checkerboards, tricycles, popcorns and plums. And he stuffed them in bags, and then the Grinch very nimbly stuffed all the bags, one by one, up the chimney.
Then the last thing he took was the log for their fire. Then he went up the chimney himself, the old liar.
Poo-poo to the Whos.
He was grinchously humming.
They're finding out now that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up. I know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open a minute or two. Then the Whos down in Whoville will all cry, boo-hoo.
Corey Otis and Austin and...
Thank you. quote.
Thank you.
from a Shakespeare text talking about wind, but using it as sort of a metaphor and comparing it to friendship. The last one talking about the wind can blow pretty cold, we're experiencing it now, but not quite as cold as friendship when it goes wrong. That's what Shakespeare was sort of talking about in that. I'll have to clear that with Mr. Otis just to make sure I have the interpretation correct. The following piece talks very simply about holding on to something that's dear to you, something that maybe someone tells you that you can't achieve or you can't attain, holding fast to a dream you have. So we talked a little bit about what holding fast means to something, because we're not talking about like speedy fast, but holding on to something really strongly. So this is a tune that gives us hope for the future. Hold fast to dreams.
Thank you.
last year, we had another student teacher. Do you remember his name?
Mr.
Jack Murphy. And he taught us this song, this version of this popular carol, Carol of the Bells. Well, I just got news. Mr. Murphy is coming to our concert tomorrow with the elementary and middle school students. He's like a celebrity around here. And so that's exciting. So he's going to have a Mr. Murphy sighting. So in his honor, we'll sing for you again. Maybe you should conduct it tomorrow.
Yes!
I should ask him first. Anyway, this is Carol of the Bells.
Christmas.
going to shout really loud. All the choirs are going to come join us now in a very, very orderly fashion, I'm sure. Safely, but quickly. We'll have a couple moment pause while we organize the troops here. Figured out. As they keep walking, I'm sure they will. I want to say a couple things before our finale. None of this would happen alone, so I want to give a big, huge shout out to Christina Kahn and Morgan Moraine for helping us out. They're hiding in the corner somewhere around here, but they're going to come out at the end, and you need to give them the biggest round of applause when that happens, because this is a team effort all around. So we'll save that applause, but in the meantime, I want to thank colleagues in the back, Heidi Conyers, Craig Heckner and Margaret LaFleur, I think, is back there too. They're all helping out in the booth. So can we give them a hand for all the help and sound? Make this a very brief story, but last time Sarah joined us on the stage, wasn't really on stage because it was the day of the cancellation due to the pandemic. We had a choir concert and it was 3:30 on that day. The choir concert was canceled, everything shut down, all the students went home, we left the building, and the only person I didn't communicate with was Sarah. And so I get a call or a text at like 7 o'clock on concert, and I'm just like, where is everyone? Oh, it's fine, we'll be back, we'll probably reschedule for next week. It's fine. Yeah, it happened. You know the rest of the story. But she's returned, which is awesome. So we're going to end tonight with a beautiful rendition of I'll Be Home for Christmas. And right before, we're going to tag a little bit of a song from a movie you might recognize. This song, it's called Count Your Blessings. And that just a reminder about all the good things that are happening in the world. And sometimes when life is rough, you got to remember the good stuff. So, on this beautiful night, thank you for being here, and I hope you enjoy our finale.
mine.